Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our live-streamed concert all the way from Side by Side Studios in Bencham in Gateshead, in association with Community Music, Whickham and Swallwell. Well, we're not allowed to visit France and Italy, but we can still go there from a musical point of view. So I'm taking you back to the late 17th and early 18th centuries and to the court of King Louis XIV, who loved his harpsichords, he loved his harpsichordists, and who was stimulated to write so much music for the Sun King. We're starting off with Louis Couperin, one of a large dynasty of composers, and three short pieces, La Pastourelle, The Country Girl, La Piemontaise, a piece from Piedmont, and a rather longer piece called a chaconne in D minor, in which it's a dance, and there's a section that keeps coming back. So here we go, La Pastourelle.
Thank you.
noticed that in the course of that piece, the sound quality changed. My harpsichord has got two sets of wires, both tuned to 8-foot pitch, that's piano pitch, and so I can play on a single set of wires. Move a lever inside and all the jacks are moved into a plucking position, so two sets of wires. There's also a device called a harp stop in which I can dampen the wires. That muffles the tone, so you can ring the changes a bit. This is not an antique harpsichord, it's about 12 years old. It was made for me by Andrew Wooderson, who was one of the finest young harpsichord makers working in England at the moment. But it's based on a harpsichord that dates back to 1673 by a gentleman called Jean Couchet, connected with the court of King Louis XIV. So, we're moving on to François Couperin now, known as Couperin le Grand, not because he was an overweight gentleman, but he was the greatest of a large dynasty of composers. So here's a set of pieces by François Couperin, La Bourbonnaise, which is a gavotte, a popular dance of the time, followed by a lovely sarabande called Les Sentiments, or Feeling, and then a rather coquettish young lady called La Manon. Mysterious. And Nobody's too sure what this means, the title, but there's one suggestion that barricade may be window dressings or curtains, or maybe even shutters. And the idea is that you might be walking down a road, down a series of terraced houses, where music making is happening. And it's the sound of one place's music blending with another, certainly some very interesting veiled harmony. You may notice a rapport between this piece and the first of the Bach 48 Preludes and Fugues, because they were both written around the year 1717, so nice link. And of course, Bach and Couperin were very good friends. They exchanged letters and they were on very good terms. And in fact, Bach used a lot of Couperin's ornamentation in his own work. So the Barricade Mystérieuse. Then after that, hiding away, I have a longer piece, which is a very lengthy passacaglia with, again, some very sonorous harmonies. I did say it was a long piece. Right. Thank you. Couperin the Great. And now we're moving on to a slightly later composer, Jean-Philippe Rameau. A lot of these composers like to give fanciful titles to their pieces, and this is from an E minor suite, and the first piece is called Le Rappel des Oiseaux, The Call of the Birds, a long French tradition of writing music which is influenced by birds, going back to Clement Jeannequin writing in the 1530s. And of course you can think of Dacquin's Le Coucou, and also Ravel's Oiseau Triste into the 20th century. So Le Rappel des Oiseaux, and then a set of dances ending up with a very well-known tambourin.
Thank you.
So that's a little bit of Jean-Philippe Rameau. Wonderful opera composer, a great theoretician. He wrote treatises on harmony. In fact, he was the first person to talk about root positions and first and second inversion chords. A really useless bit of information for you. We're now moving on to Antoine Forqueray, who died in 1745. He was not himself a harpsichordist, he was actually a very fine viol player. And when he died, his son collected a lot of the viol pieces. Viols were going out of fashion then, but the harpsichord was still enormously popular. And he transferred them from the viol to the harpsichord medium. They're set in a very low texture, so we're getting a lot of the very low notes in the harpsichord coming through. Two pieces. First of all, La Belmont. Forqueray's best friend was a gentleman, the Marquis de Belmont, himself a fine violinist, a fine viol player. And the second piece, I'm chanting this one, it's another wild piece called La Portugaise. It's either a piece in the Portuguese style, or it might be a Portuguese young lady. It's got touches of virtuosity in it, otherwise known as fast notes. So La Belmont and La Portugaise.
Thank you.
rather good fun, that piece, and yes, I really enjoyed learning that. So, we're now going to get into our assorted modes of transport, and we're going to go over the Alps, and we're going to Italy, and we're going back to the early 1700s, and to a gentleman called Scarlatti, but not Domenico, but to his father, Alessandro Scarlatti, who was born in 1660. Best known as an opera composer and a composer of cantatas and of wonderful songs, he was also a harpsichordist. I copied this music out from the British Museum, and I doubt if it's ever been performed before. It's variations on a tune called La Folia, Le Folie d'Espagne. So I'll play the melody through first, and then a series of very gentle variations on it. So, a world premiere, I suspect. Alessandro, to his son, Domenico Scarlatti, who, although he was born in Italy, spent most of his working life first of all in Portugal, and then as harpsichord teacher and composer in ordinary to the Queen of Spain. He wrote over 600 sonatas, and here are two of the earliest ones, one in D minor, followed by one in C major.
Thank you.
recital, a suite in G minor by a very little-known composer called Domenico Zeppoli. He worked in Rome, he was the organist at Santa Maria Maggiore, and he wrote a set of suites for the harpsichord, which were published in the early 1700s by Walsh. He then decided to become a priest, and he got on a boat and he went to South America, to Rio de Janeiro, and I'm afraid he hasn't been heard of since. But the music is still with us, and I think it's a very elegant set of four movements, absolutely typical Baroque suite, a prelude, largo, a courant, a most elegant saraband, and rather an exuberant jig, which could almost be Northumbrian rant. So see what you make of it. In the slow movements, I'm doing a little bit of ornamentation, which you may or may not consider to be tasteful. It's different every time. So here we go, Domenico Zeppoli's Suite in G minor.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, is the end of today's live stream concert from Side by Side Studios in Gateshead. Thank you for joining me. And a quick plug, our next event is going to be a performance of Vivaldi's Four Seasons with Bradley Kresek and members of the Northern Sinfonia Orchestra on the 21st of June. And they've invited me to play the harpsichord with them. So see you then. Thank you.